Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
The big picture of our city right now includes many very positive elements. We're very proud of the fact that this is a safer city than ever. It's a city with more jobs than ever. It's a city where our kids are graduating from our schools at a higher rate than ever. There's a lot of things to be proud of. But there's also problems that we haven't solved that we need to do more on. And homelessness, and particularly street homelessness, remains one of the core challenges that we need to address. Last December, we announced a very different approach. We announced something that had never been tried before on the scale you will now see in this city. We announced NYC Homeless Outreach and Mobile Engagement Street Action Team, otherwise known as HomeStat. You can clap for that, that's good. And there has never been anything like HomeStat previously in this city or in any other major city in the country, an absolutely comprehensive approach where we're going to use all the tools of government working with our nonprofit partners to reach folks who are living on our streets, not only some of the time, but on a very, very consistent basis, and to reach people in a way that will make a real change in their lives and the lives of our communities. We are proud to say that HomeStat is now up and running. It's still building out, but we have a very robust effort underway now, and it's already starting to make an impact. And today we're going to explain how HomeStat is working, how it will build out further, and what it's going to mean for the lives of our communities and for people who are homeless and in need. Let me just thank, there's a lot of people with us because such a huge effort, such a big initiative requires a lot of different leaders and a lot of different elements. I want to thank a number of the people who are here, and you'll hear from some others who will speak after me. I want to thank our Deputy Mayor for Health and Human Services, Dr. Herminia Palacio, our Chief of Department, FDNY, Jim Leonard. Our Chief Commissioner for FDNY, Dan Nigro, our Commissioner for Department of Sanitation, Catherine Garcia, President of the Health and Hospitals Corporation, Ram Raju, Executive Director of 311, Joseph Morris-Rowe, Mindy Tarlow, Director of the Mayor's Office of Operations, Dr. George Askew, Deputy Commissioner for the Department of Health, and Chief Bill Morris of the NYPD, and I want to thank officers from the Homeless Outreach Unit of the NYPD who are here with us today. Also, a number of other outreach workers who are part of the HomeStat effort are here with us. I want to thank them for the great work they do. You'll be seeing these distinctive vests a lot more around the city. And when you see those vests, it means that someone who is highly trained in how to help the homeless and help them off the streets is on the job and addressing the situation at the front. So I want to thank all the folks who do this important homeless outreach work, including folks who come from organizations such as the Goddard Riverside Community Center, Bronx Works, the Bowery Residents Committee, Project Hospitality, and Breaking Ground. I also want to thank, because we're in her community board district, the district manager for Community Board 3, Susan Stetzer. So people are working together to make HomeStat a reality because we're talking about a complicated problem, a problem that's been going on in this city for decades. It needs a different approach. It needs something much bigger and more comprehensive, and that's what HomeStat will be. Now, at the outset, we have to be clear. We see people on the streets, and a lot of times we assume if someone's panhandling, if someone's out on the street, that they are homeless. As Commissioner Bratton has often said, there are people who are on our streets during daytime hours who are not homeless. There are some people who panhandle for whatever reason, but that's not because they're homeless. That's a separate challenge that we need to address. But when it comes to folks who are permanently homeless, folks who literally spend 24 hours on the streets, that's a group of people who need a very special kind of help and a very focused kind of help. We know that all over the country, this challenge has been one that local governments have taken on, but no one's cracked the code, no one's come up with the perfect solution. That's why we had to try something different and bigger and more substantial to try and really change the course of this reality. Homestat is based on the notion that we have to have a plan for each and every person who is homeless on our streets. We literally have to understand each person's situation and what it's going to take to change that situation. Each and every one of the folks living on our streets had a path from a better life to the streets. We need to find them a path from the streets to a better life. We need to help them back to normalcy. We have to help them get back on their feet. And the way to do that is to go out to the homeless, to engage them consistently, to understand what they need, to really drill down and be there every single day to make a difference. And that begins with knowing where people are, understanding the shape of the problem, and measuring literally every single day what's going on our streets. You know, previously, it was an annual count of the homeless taken one day in winter at night. This is very, very different. This is a daily count every day, looking for where the problems and challenges are, looking for where there's people in need. Each day, 32 city workers, this is already happening, are walking every single block from Canal Street to 145th Street, Manhattan. Literally every block from Canal up to 145th. That's 307 street miles a day, over 2,000 miles a week. Right there at the grassroots, looking for the homeless, looking for what their needs are, looking how we can address the situation. In addition, we have teams that focus on 18 hotspots in outer borough areas. It's a moment where I want to note, there used to be for decades in this town, homeless encampments, literally places that were villages, in effect, where people lived. We ended that practice last year. We don't accept the notion that any homeless person should be living in an encampment. It's not fair to them. It's not fair to our communities. We've ended the homeless encampments, and we'll make sure they don't reassert. But there still are hotspots, meaning places where some folks who are homeless 24/7 congregate. And that's a place where we can gather to support them and serve them. Now, starting on May 2nd, these teams that we've trained to do the counting and to figure out the best ways we can support the homeless will fan out all over the city to do nighttime counts as well. We will do those three times a year. So we're going to do nighttime counts, which give us a different look at what's happening, but we don't want to just do one annual count. We want to start to do those more often. And all this information will be made public. Public will be able to see this data at nyc.gov/homestat. In fact, you can visit the site today, and it'll show you what our outreach workers have seen most recently, and the site is constantly going to be updated to show more information as it comes in. The key to this, once we've identified consistently where people are, is to figure out what they need individually. Some people might accept service the first time it's offered. They might accept a warm bed, they might accept medical attention, food, they might accept mental health services or substance abuse services the very first time, but we know that's not typically the case. For a lot of folks, it will take 10 times, 20 times, 50 times of being engaged before they'll agree to the help they need. And that's where we take all the tools of government and combine them to help people. Some people will need to access Social Security benefits or veterans benefits that they haven't gotten. We'll help them do it. Some, again, as I said, may need mental health support. We'll get it for them. Or a doctor's visit. We'll arrange it for them. Some people may need to be reconnected with their families. And it'll be our job to find their family members and see if we can reunify them in a productive way. But it all comes down to knowing each individual and what they need. Over 500 staff from city agencies and nonprofits will gather together in this effort. This is a really extraordinary effort to send people out and provide that support. As many of you know, we have been engaged over the last few months in a reevaluation of all our efforts to address homelessness. There was a 90-day review period. And as a result of the 90-day review period, one of the determinations we made was that the HomeStat initiative needed a very seasoned leader to bring all the strands together, to take a brand new approach and make it work. We're going to have more to say on other elements of the 90-day review next week and beyond. But today I'm proud to announce that leadership for the HomeStat effort will be provided by our new senior HomeStat advisor, Dr. Michael Jacobson. Michael is a colleague who many of us have served with in government over the years. He has the distinction of being both an extraordinary public servant who's run big agencies, run big nonprofits, served with distinction in both the Giuliani and Dinkins administrations as both probation commissioner and corrections commissioner. So someone who knows how to deal with very big challenges and knows how to get results. And you'll hear from Michael in just a moment. I want to emphasize that it's not just a leader like Michael and the 500 men and women who will be doing the outreach effort, and the members of the NYPD homeless outreach team. All of these people are part of the solution, but every New Yorker can also be part of the solution. Because every New Yorker can report what they see, and we want people to call into 311. If you see a homeless person in distress, if you know someone has been at the same corner, if you know something that that person needs, call it in. Call it in. We want to find each homeless person and address their needs. So everyone can be eyes and ears in this process and can call 311 with the information they have. Just a few words in Spanish. Me complace anunciar que HomeStat, el programa más completo del país para ayudar a personas sin hogar en las calles, ya está trabajando a toda marcha. Nuestros trabajadores caminan más de 2,000 millas por semana buscando desamparados para conectarlos con los servicios que necesitan. Por favor, recuerden llamar al 311 si ven a alguien que necesite ayuda en nuestras calles. With that, I want to bring forward Michael Jacobson. Again, an extraordinary career in public service, a great sense of how to move both government and the nonprofit sector in common cause. I want to thank him for stepping up for the city in which he was born and bred, a true New Yorker, answering the call to duty and helping us to innovate what will be a brand new and exciting approach to addressing this problem. Dr. Michael Jacobson.
Thank you, Mayor. The mayor, one of the things the mayor didn't say is that I met the mayor now, sadly, 27 years ago when we were both working for Mayor Dinkins, and I am happy to say, though, that it's clear that neither he nor I have aged a day during that time.
That was believable.
Data-driven. So when he asked me to help out, I was delighted, and it's nice to be working with him and his team again, especially on this issue, especially on homelessness. It's one of the biggest, obviously most complicated social issue. As the mayor was saying, our city faces, it's multi-systemic. It crosses agencies, systems, levels of government, involves issues of income, mental health, physical health, hugely difficult and complicated family situations, drug and alcohol addiction. And, you know, in the end, it's a hugely vulnerable population, and these folks are our mothers, fathers, brothers, relatives, teenagers, families, veterans, returning prisoners. They are, although they present a lot of quality of life issues, they are one of the most vulnerable populations in the city. We have too many of them living on the streets, and I think with the right help, we can reach them. We can improve their lives, and we will do that. And I think the HomeStat approach, the approach that the mayor described briefly, combines, for me, I think, the essential elements of what I think of both on an individual level as grand rounds, to use a medical analogy. It's not a perfect analogy, but I think it's right in some ways to deal with the individuals, the most difficult and tractable cases, but where that learning also informs policy and practice, right? So it goes from the individual to policy and from policy to the individual. It can't work without a group of dedicated staff and agency leaders who you see here, and I think the approach is, you know, sort of spot on for the complexity of this issue. As the mayor mentioned quickly, I spent most of my career in government, either running agencies with Mindy Tarlo. I worked in the budget office as well. I've run large not-for-profits and currently in academia. And the thread, at least for my career, is I've always been involved in one way or another doing this kinds of systemic work, especially work that focuses on vulnerable populations. When I was a commissioner at DOC, we built their version of CompStat. It was called Teams. It was their performance indicator and accountability system. And Teams was hugely integral to driving down violence and overtime and sick time in the early 2000s in DOC. When I was at Vera, we were invited by the city of New Orleans and the federal government to create a pretrial agency in New Orleans where none had existed before, so that people in poverty who were being held could not be released. We built that. We dealt with the hugely complicated systems in New Orleans. New Orleans has since then has had one of the most massive jail declines of any city in the United States. More recently at CUNY, where I'm now a professor and run an institute, we created an empirical indicator system to measure inequality over time in New York and other cities. We also oversee a large kind of 20-city effort to work with agencies in those cities to look at racial and ethnic disparities in their criminal justice system and to shrink the size of their incarceration systems. So this HomeStat is the kind of work I love to do. It's hugely important. It's complex. The mayor's put together a great team of committed agency heads. He's asked for real, demonstrable, measurable results that everyone is committed to getting. And in terms of getting folks off the street into safer, more appropriate spaces. And finally, just on a personal note, again, it's not only great to be back and working with the mayor, but also colleagues like Tony Shores, who was the first deputy mayor, and Mindy Tarlo, the head of operations. We were all worked in OMB back in the day, and it's lovely to be working with old friends and colleagues again. And Mayor, thanks again for asking me to do this.
Thank you. He's a very honest and sincere and believable guy, except for he does look a little different. But other than that, perfect. I want to bring up Commissioner Steve Banks a moment. I just want to note that over these last months, there's been extraordinary work done, even as HomeStat was being created. You know, we had some really bitter nights over the course of the winter, and so many of our public employees went out to help the homeless. Folks from FDNY, our firefighters, our EMTs, went out, brought people in. NYPD, Department of Health, Department of Homeless Services. So many of our first responders and our health workers all saw it as their common responsibility to look for folks in need. And you remember during the Code Blue days, we would tell you about the numbers each day of folks who were brought in, gotten the help they need, gotten the medical care they need. That is something that every day this city does, looking out for people. But with HomeStat, we're going to be able to do something much more systemic and much deeper and really get to the root of the problem. I just want to take another moment to thank everyone. Everyone from FDNY, everyone from PD, Health, DHS, all of our nonprofit partners, because, you know, they, every single time, made people's lives better. They convinced people to come in. They made a real difference time and time again, and we don't thank them enough for that. So I want to take this opportunity to say a profound thank you to each and every one of them. Now it's my pleasure to introduce the commissioner for HRA, and Steve has been doing an outstanding job helping to develop these new strategies. And for us, although we know it's a big challenge, we know that we are putting the right tools on the table to make a difference. HRA Commissioner Steve Banks.
It's good to see everybody out here in this beautiful weather. But when it's important to remember when we're out here in this beautiful weather that we had the team that the mayor described, Department of Homeless Services, FDNY, EMS, Police Department, and our terrific not-for-profit partners helping 27 people come in off the streets last night in a particularly cold weather. We're not used to seeing that in April all the time, but nonetheless, people were out last night doing the work that is so important. Homestat is something that no city has tried before. There have been outreach efforts going back over decades, but no city has tried to put together this kind of team effort that joins together frontline not-for-profit staff who are out there night after night trying to bring people in with Department of Homeless Services staff, with the other agency staff, to look at each person individually, but also to look at the systemic things that we can learn from each case through a citywide case management system. That's what's going to make the difference, and I'm so happy to have Michael with us with all of his experience and all of his wisdom, and to be working with the Mayor's Office of Operations and under Mindy Tarlow's leadership to bring together all of the agencies in one team to address homelessness. As many of you know, I've been working with homeless people in the city for more than three decades, and I have never seen this kind of citywide effort to address this problem. The 25 people that were able to be brought into placements last week when the weather was nicer are testament to what has been going on over these last weeks as we have been implementing Homestat. It starts with you, the public, calling 311. Or it starts with a city worker who sees somebody. And I encourage you to call 311 because that's how help starts if we don't see the person. But these are human beings, and the 311 calls matter. The canvassing by city staff to identify people matter. That results in an evaluation about whether it's a law enforcement matter, in which case the police should be deployed, or whether it's a situation in which we want to try to give somebody a helping hand. And the partnership between Department of Homeless Services and the Police Department's Homeless Outreach Team is another important element. The mayor announced this back in December that instead of having different approaches in the police department would have a special unit. That is really helping us. It helped us this winter to have that kind of an approach. And once that call comes in, either the police department goes out or our outreach workers go out, and then the process of engagement begins. The road to get to the street, the path to get to the streets was not a linear one for people, and it's not easy to get them off. But the kind of sustained attention, the sustained focus that Homestat is bringing to bear is so critical. And when we succeed, every person we can bring in is a success, but we want to succeed to keep people off the street on an ongoing basis. And that's where the case management effort that Michael is going to be helping us put together is so critical, because that's what's going to make the difference in people who thus far have resisted help. Our outreach workers try repeatedly to bring people in, and they succeed. But where they don't succeed, we want to bring to bear all the resources of the city for individuals who have resisted help to get them the help that matches what their needs are and bring them in. And we're going to keep after this case by case, as we proceed forward. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you very much, Steve. I want to bring up one of the leaders of the nonprofit efforts to reach people on the streets. And I have to tell you, some of you were with us a few weeks back. We were in the subways and we were talking to folks on a very cold day. And when you see, I was absolutely moved by the outreach workers who were with me, because they had such compassion for the folks who they were speaking to, and they understood the complexities of what people have been through. And they really worked to persuade each homeless person to come in and get the help they needed. And there was something almost pastoral about it. The fact that they thought so deeply about each person as an individual and really listened for what they needed, in many cases knew the individuals over months or even years. So this is such important work, such really dignified work, and I want to thank everyone who does it. And as an example of this good work, I want to bring forward Bill Hughes, the program director for Street to Home Manhattan.
I'd like to say thank you to Mayor de Blasio and to Commissioner Banks for giving me the opportunity to share a little bit about the great work that all of the street outreach teams are doing on a daily basis. I've been working with the street outreach teams in various capacities for 6 years, and I'm honored to have had the opportunity to have worked with great nonprofit organizations like Breaking Ground, the Center for Urban Community Services, and Goddard Riverside. All wonderful agencies that do great work. There's never a quick fix to the set of circumstances that cause someone to become street homeless. Helping someone move from living on the street to finding a permanent home is a process that I have seen take months or in some cases even years. I've witnessed firsthand, however, how the persistence, compassion, and sincerity of an outreach worker can help a person that some might consider too far gone to eventually come inside and accept housing. This even includes people with severe mental illness that I have personally witnessed scream at a worker on the first engagement or even run away from an outreach worker in the beginning of engagement. The thing about the outreach teams is that they don't give up on people. The persistence and compassion is ultimately what helps someone who may have been let down their whole lives or whose mental illness prevents them from trusting anyone, finally get into housing. No matter how far they fall or how low they go, the teams will always be there to lend them a hand. Not only do people find homes, but with the assistance provided in support of housing, they often find jobs, reconnect with family members, and go on to live full and enriched lives. The team at Breaking Ground Street to Home Manhattan is very excited to see the mayor's commitment to provide additional resources to those living on the street. This includes funding to increase the number of outreach workers, creating more safe havens, and bringing on more supportive housing units. With these additional resources and the ongoing commitment of compassionate and skilled outreach workers, we are excited to be able to make an even larger impact for those living on the street. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Finally, we've had tremendous support in this initiative from the City Council, and the City Council members are crucial voices in helping us think about how we approach each community and people in need in the community, but also try to address the quality of life needs of all of the residents of the community. And in particular, I want to thank Councilmember Ben Kalos for his focus on these issues and his support. Welcome him to speak. Councilmember Ben Kalos.
Thank you to Mayor de Blasio and Commissioner Steve Banks for leading this effort and really taking on the homeless crisis. And thank you to all the agencies that are here today and every day and every night. I see the fire department, NYPD, DOHMH, APS, DSNY, and our partners in the nonprofits. We can't solve this problem alone, but together we can make a difference. I hear a lot about calling 301. I also want to make sure, and this will make Mindy Tarlow happy, you can use the 301 app. It'll take that 3 to 5 minute 301 call down to a 30-second press of a button on your phone. So if calling 301 is too inconvenient, just press that button on your 311 app. And so Homestat is absolutely spectacular. It's taken a lot of the different pieces that we need. So first, we're proactively canvassing every day, and that is huge. We have the Hope Count, which HUD mandates, but we only do that once a year, and it's usually on the coldest night. It's been rescheduled in the past 2 years because it was always so cold, and we've been getting what I think are probably lower numbers than otherwise, but the fact that we're actually going to go out and start doing this on a quarterly basis in warm months and in cold months so we can get an accurate count of how many people are really on the street is a big deal. And all of this is coupled with the fact that it's going to be happening transparently so that residents can see the results, see what's happening. And so we're a big supporter of this, and we've also gotten a coalition together on the East Side for the East Side Task Force for Homeless Outreach and Services. We work closely with HRA and DHS to make sure that the faith-based institutions can participate in all the programs that this mayor is rolling out.
from opening doors to supportive housing. I will get supportive housing built in my district with your help. We will take your money to do so. And anything we can do to help the people who are on the streets, off the streets. I just want to take one quick moment to just talk about who the homeless are. And so it's not just this big number out there. It's 23,000 children. We have children who wake up in a homeless shelter and go to public schools in my district. The next big number is 17,000 families. 17,000 family members who have these children, and they're waking up in a shelter, and then they're going to work, they're caring for their families. And then we have about 13,000 or so single adults. But when we talk about homeless, and as I remind my constituents day in, day out, is these aren't people who have ever really done anything, especially when you're talking about children and families. This is a symptom of the affordable housing crisis and the fact that people get forced out and they're on the streets. And luckily, we've done something about that on MIATQA under this mayor's leadership. So hopefully, taken together, we'll continue to chip away at the problem one person at a time, 25 people at a time, and together we can and will make this city great. Thank you.
We're going to take questions on this topic, but I also want to say you see such a range of agencies here. Catherine Garcia is here because sanitation plays a crucial role in helping us keep, of course, all communities clean. It also plays a role when we make sure that if people have left stuff behind that is going to take away from the quality of life of a community, that sanitation is there to clean it up. Our Parks Department plays a role. We work closely with them. Want to thank everyone here from the Parks Department, including the folks who do enforcement for the parks and the officers who patrol the parks. We thank all of them for the good work they do. We look at this as an effort across all our agencies, and Homestead is going to bring all that energy and all that capacity together. Again, want to thank Mike Jacobson for stepping up and bringing his leadership and his experience to this effort. All right, happy to take questions on this topic.
Can Dr. Jacobson step up to the mic? I have a question. Your former boss, Mayor Giuliani, has been fairly critical of this mayor. What do you make of his criticism?
You know, I make of it that it's political. You know, my job here is not to, you know, sort of take apart the sort of politics of this or the sort of critical political arguments that go on. There's a real social issue here that's been apparent for every mayor, right? This is, you know, I started with Koch, right? And homelessness was a key issue back then, and it's been for every single mayor that's had this job. And this is probably the most focused and resource-intensive attention that's been paid to it. And as a result of that, you know, it's fair for the public and for the mayor to expect results. So, you know, those kinds of criticisms, I'll let the, you know, the big dogs handle, right? I mean, my job is to work with Mindy and her staff and the agency heads to try to get something done.
Well, respectfully, Mayor Giuliani says the approach is wrong. He says that's, I think his words were, tough love is required. Do you agree with him on that?
You know, I don't even know what that means exactly.